Life in slow motion, feet are in the clay. I'm going nowhere, been standing here all day. I had a notion there was something more to do. As I watched the water from the banks of the river, it swelled and grew. And I tilt to the left, lean to the right, tilt to the left, lean to the right. Walked on coal and slept on glass amid swords of sound and daggers of light. And my heart is screaming, 'cause half of what I say is lies, and it takes so much to keep up this disguise. It takes so much to keep up this disguise. I see a doorway in the haze, and I'm trying to get to it. The stars are peepholes in a wall, but we can walk through it. The memory's still so real, the memory's still so real. I guess it's never really over, even when it's over. But I'm vibrating with love and light, pulsating with love and light. In a world gone mad, a world gone mad, it must be something more than this. I'm vibrating with love and light, pulsating with love and light. In a world gone mad, a world gone mad, there must be something more. And the trumpet call is sounding, the trees are bending low, there's a great fire in the distance. There must be something more than this. And our shadows will all be dancing with red dust on our clothes when we leave by a tornado. Elbows in the clouds and feet in the sky. Vibrating with love and light, pulsating with love and light. In a world gone mad, a world gone mad, there must be something more than this. We're vibrating with love and light, pulsating with love and light. In a world gone mad, a world gone mad, there must be something more.
Devil's drawing near, 46 days and the cool went out. 46 Spill on the ground after this amazing journey that the Legos have made to perfection with computers. Anyway. I'm also a big fan of it. Whoever writes the music for that show deserves a shout out. And I mean that. The music for Happy Man. Okay, let me play this one. you're just staring at your walls, observing echoing footfalls from tenants wandering distant halls, this one is for you. If children playing all around, to you is noise, not pleasant sound, and you'd be lost on the playground. This one is for you, all alone the life you lead, a silent diner where you feed. You bow your head, pretend to read. This one is for you. Just a satellite high above the atmosphere, bouncing everything you say to someone who was meant to hear. Sometimes on a rainy day, I lie in bed and dream of you. So blame it on the satellite when your message can't get through. I am just a tiny wave, a minor ripple out at sea, moving slowly toward the shore, burdened with uncertainty. I'm gaining power, losing speed, wondering as I near your door, will you hold it open for the tidal wave approaching shore? I'm an island in the hazy world surrounding me, offering a vast reward each time I safely cross the sea. All too often I become lost in the fog and haze, clinging still against my will to promises of clearer days. I am just a raindrop that accelerates without control, losing bits and pieces in descent till I'm no longer whole. I am just another shooting star above that you might see, until I have your full attention I'll be anything but me. Anything but me. Man, this is really a pleasure, I gotta say. Got a bunch of friends here tonight. All of you, all of you. That's what I mean. I got a bunch of friends here. Thank you, Mike. This is kind of unplanned. Thank you. That's my guitar. That's right. I have to shout out one friend. I have to. Is this right? Yeah. Molly, are you out there? Molly Cullen? There's a bunch of us that went to high school together. And the person I just shouted out, I haven't seen in a very long time. Maybe since high school. Almost. Okay, this is right. Don't wanna be an actor pretending on the stage. Don't wanna be a writer with my thoughts out on the page. Don't wanna be a painter, 'cause everyone comes to look. Don't wanna be anything where my life's an open book. A dream, it's true, but I'd see it through. If I could be wasting my time with you. Don't wanna be a farmer working in the sun. Don't wanna be an outlaw always on the run. Don't wanna be a climber reaching for the top. Don't wanna be anything. I don't know when to stop. A dream, it's true, but I'd see it through. If I could be wasting my time. Don't believe what you might have read. You'll see what I might have said. To hear it, don't waste your time. Said to hear it.
time with me. Come waste your time with me. Come waste your time with me.
Brother, brother, brother.
all those chemtrails raining down on you. The justice of the peace can't help you anymore. And they just took the covers off the justice of war. You got your nightshades on, and the worst days are gone. So now the band plays on. You got one light blaze on. You got your nightshades on, and the worst days are gone. So now the band plays on. You got one light blaze on. The storm is passing through. Lay down your sticks and stones. The struggle's over now. We're all just flesh and bones. We were wrong before. It was wrong to trust. The shadows cast were only light and dust. And then one day you find, to your intense delight, that three wrong turns can really make a right. So why not be like me? Be proud of all your crimes. 'Cause when I screw up, I do it too.
Fish had just first started. We were working locally around Burlington. I was working I used to work at the pet food warehouse. Carrying the 50-pound bags. And Fish was a ticket taker at a parking garage. So I'd always come out. And I don't know if any of you guys are Facebook friends with Fish, but if you are, you know that he gets very obsessed with, like, I like telling stories about Fish. That's my favorite guy. But, like, he gets into something and he really gets into it. And so, what got just popped into my mind was that when we were roommates back then, he started wanting to eat healthier, and he discovered wheatgrass, right? So he started by taking a shot of wheatgrass down at the health food store, and then he read somewhere, because this is kind of his pattern, he's kind of obsessed with things, that the wheatgrass would be better if you grew it at your own house. So he got these like 50-gallon tubs of dirt, and our house was filthy. It was like three guys living together, you know, and nobody ever cleaned anything. So he got this special dirt that was flown in from, you know, wherever, the hills of Thailand or something, and these wheatgrass seeds, and he kept getting more and more obsessed with it. The next thing you know, our kitchen had this wheatgrass grinder, and all he ever talked about was wheatgrass. It was just wheatgrass, wheatgrass, wheatgrass. So anyway, one day, I come home, and I walk in the front door. This is a completely true story here. And he had made some decision that it wasn't working well enough by drinking the wheatgrass, and I walked in the front door and I opened the door and Fish was lying on his back with like his butt to the door, giving himself a wheatgrass enema. he had like a big rubber syringe in one hand and a white towel, and there was like green juice all over the white towel. Unsee that. No, you're never gonna unsee it. No, you're never gonna unsee it. I'm so sorry. I can't go from that to that. It's too horrible. Thank you. you're smiling at me from your picture frame, and I miss you. Every morning I wake up and I whisper your name. I miss you. You're in faces of people I see on the street. You're everywhere. You're everywhere.
Ooh.
Thank you. All right, I'll do this then. Wow, this is so quiet here. So all these friends that are here tonight, I just want to say this, so I will. It's my friend Chris Lee is in the audience, and my friend Sean is Lee, and my friend Molly, I think, my friend Kevin, and we all had a very dear mutual friend, my friend Seacott, who's the hero of the Push On Till the Day song, and thanks so much. This guy, I think, is a guy that I truly loved so much, and we lost him a couple weeks ago to cancer, very sadly, I sat out there with him. You know, this guy's a friend since 15 years old, and I sat with him on the couch for the last, you know, week that he was with us, and just played the guitar, and very quietly, and he was kind of breathing, and he would kind of, it's amazing that I'm talking about this, my friend Sean, who's in the audience, was there with me, and he would sort of breathe, and he was kind of like sleeping for like many, many hours, and I'd just play real quietly, you know, and then I would stop, and he would kind of open his eyes and go, and I'd say, hey man, and I'd look at him and go, hey, how you doing? And so I started writing this thing that I'm gonna play now. And it's sad, you know, but it kind of goes between sad and memories of all these good times we had together, because there was a lot of them, a lot of good times. And so I'm gonna dedicate this to I wanna dedicate this to everybody in the audience who's thinking, yeah, I just went through that too, because it's probably pretty much just about everybody in here, the way things go, and so we all feel this. I didn't know what to call this, so I'm just going to call it Till We Meet Again or something like that, because that's what I hope. I'm going to hope that. Let's see if I can... your world I fell. Without you now I wander soaking, secretly afraid. But in your grass the fears don't last, though some of them have. Thank you.
Won't find a moment
compliments in a box, and someone else will set your clocks. I took a bullet from my way. I've been waiting in the velvet sea. I've been waiting in the velvet sea. I've been waiting in the velvet sea. I've been waiting in the, I've been waiting in the, I've been waiting in the velvet sea. I've been waiting in the velvet sea. I've been waiting in the velvet sea.
Bye.
practically distinct from doing things smart people don't do. He was 10, he was once a lizard too. His name was Rutherford the Brave, and he was on a quest to save his people from the fate that lay before them. They're clumsy and was perilously near. The lizards would be saved, he said, if they could be enlightened by the writings of the Herring Friendly Book. In all of Russia, only one existed. And Wilson had declared that any person who possessed it was a crook. He said, I come from the land of darkness. He said, I come from the land.
Oh,
Man, that chord, that song has so many chords in it. My God! 8,000 chords in that song. Normally I just like page play them, I just kind of... With the chicken, with the chicken. I decided that, by the way, that wah-wah pedals were sexy. Are they? Were they just for like a couple of years there in the 70s? Man, that's just the thing. I started high school in the 70s. That shows you how old I am. But I did. I started high school in the 70s. I just remember going to like high school dances, and you'd go every band. This is like when I wanted to be in a band. Every band looked like 1978 Lynyrd Skynyrd. Like they all had long hair, like the guitars and the like flying V guitars and huge gear. So like I can remember going to, you know, my middle school dance with Susanna Goodman, my date. You know, like real awkward, we're like 14 years old. You know, nobody's on the dance floor, and it's like in the gym and there's chaperones and people's moms and stuff. And like, you know, one couple is like out there and boy is like got his arm like a foot from him. And like up on the stage is this band like with hair down to here, you know, like huge amplifiers and all this stuff, like it was amazing. It was an amazing time to grow up, and maybe want to be in a band. I should be playing music, but I just gotta tell you one more thing, and then I'll stop talking, I swear. I remember going over, having this moment where I went over to my friend Eric's house, Eric Jensen. He had two older brothers, and I was like in eighth grade or something like that. And we went over to his house. It must have been, well, how old are you in eighth grade? Like 13 or something? How old? 14, so I was born in 64, so anyway. 78, it was 1978. And these guys had a motorcycle. And like a garage. And so me and Eric went over, and his brothers were like long hair, and you know, they were, you know, 18 or 20 years old or something like that. And they had this motorcycle on blocks, and they were drinking tall boy cans and smoking like dirt weed and revving the motor of the motor, like, let me try some beer and like some, you know, some pot. And then the guy put, I remember he put on Mississippi Queen. It was like, I want to do that. That's what I wanted. Greatest day ever. Life changing. Anyway, I'm not talking anymore. Thanks, you guys. Thank you, Susan. Thank you for being so patient. Thank you. my friend, he's got a knife. A statement from his former life, when he was easy but alone. Beside him was an empty throne, but what of silver silken blade? A fix his gaze, his features stayed. Grasps the handle, clips the cable. One steps up, sits at his table. My friend, he's got a knife. My friend, he's got a knife. A hidden relic from his past that wasn't there when he looked last. He feels it ticking like a bomb, feeding fear, assaulted calm. Takes the object, starts the game, moves it closer to the flame. My friend, the clothes. My friend, he likes the feelings. Thank you.
sun. All my past are crystal clear, they come slowly down the gun. Can't just wait till I'm old.
Thank you.
down the line with eyes wide open, somewhere in between the past and future, where you drift in time. You can't see a different point of view. You decide what it contains, how long it goes, but this remains the only words. But this remains, the only rule is it begins.
The worst one. I must inquire, Wilson.